as far as drugs and alcohol were concerned, I think it played an enormous part in the demise of my spirit, of my energy, of my physical energy, of my life. Therefore, as a band member, I was utterly diminished, completely diminished. I had very little to give, even though I tried to give, I had very little to offer, because I didn't know that I was being eaten alive by drugs and alcohol. I'm the real thing, man. I'm not pretend. When I drink and when I use, I have to go to hospital and or I have to lie on a hospital bed chained down. They're strapped down. I've been there. I've been through the mental institutions. I've done that. I've been in lockdowns, all kinds of horrible places. This is not fun. It's not cool for me to drink.
I think that was the beginning of the breakup of the band and it sort of the bond between us went. It was like we all reacted differently to drugs and we became different kind of people. And the more dependent we were on it, the more the music suffered and the more we disagreed with each other. And in the end, we didn't even speak to each other.
I was stoned all the time and so I didn't really appreciate what was going on around me. And I was into the sex, drugs and the rock and roll, and the rock and roll was paying for my sex and the drugs.
Everything was distorted. And, you know, really they were, when looking back now, I can look back at that, you know, and go, well, that was a pretty sad lifestyle, Bill.
We were doing too much and we got to too much of a state that we couldn't function, you know, properly on it. And you were getting angry and aggressive and, you know, sort of, because we were doing too much of everything.
I mean, I should be dead. We all should be fucking dead, what we were with the shit that we were fucking abusing motherfuckers, man. We used to rape and pillage everywhere we went. We were fucking nuts.
I know what drugs and alcohol did for me, and it's the real thing. It is the real thing, too. So, life and death, man. Life and death, man.